supposed to be sending that?
No, 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 you, he has.
I'm supposed to be sending that, okay. Right, so once again, thank you very much for having me here tonight, and thank you, Jack, for this very wonderful invitation. And as he said, this is my first time at the Toastmasters Hall. Back in university days, I participated once or twice. I haven't been very faithful, a faithful follower, so guilty as charged. Right, so Jack would like me to give some comments. Well, I am probably just sobbing here for your, I don't know who's going to be your long-term language evaluator, but I'm only sobbing here. Please excuse me if I look like I'm at my wit's end. So Jack, what would you like me to do? I'm putting him on the spot.
Okay, our language evaluator today, she is going to tell us some mistakes that we regularly put into our speaking, and some grammar, some usage of the words, what kind of method we should use the words into, what kind of circumstances, and what things that we have already put into our speaking. Yes, that's right.
Well, Jack specifically asked me not to comment on individual speakers, especially in the manual speaker session, is that he doesn't want it to be too personal. Am I right, Jack? He doesn't want me to be too personal. But I think if it... okay, so I'm not going to say who made this mistake or anything like that. I'm just going to take you through some things that I noticed during your presentations. And I have to say, I was very, very impressed with the three speakers and also the evaluators. Several of you had excellent spot-on English accent, perfect. And you have very good poise. I don't know if you know this word. When you are delivering a speech, it's very important you have a very good poise. 台风很稳. And I think, oh, okay. And I think all the speakers tonight managed to pull that off very well. Oh, I'm not very comfortable with the microphone because my voice is just so beautiful. One gentleman was talking about if he was going to have a restaurant and what kind of food he was going to serve. Okay, and I noticed that the lady who was hosting that session, oh, I'm not supposed to name
Kiki.
Yes, okay, sorry, Kiki. Kiki actually said that what food would you like to sell? But it would be better if you say what food would you like to serve instead of sell. Serving food, if you have a restaurant, that means you're selling that food anyway. But people would prefer to use the word serve instead of sell. Okay. And then one gentleman said he would like to serve curry. But the gentleman probably said curry or something. But I think you meant curry. Yeah? Yeah. Sorry, Tony. Unfortunately, I can't... okay, and then one lady was here, she was caught on the spot, and she said, okay, she was doing this gesture, but actually she was a little bit tongue-tied, and I think what she wanted to say is, my mind goes blank. Yeah? Okay, you can see my mind goes blank when I'm put on the spot. Right. wonderful speakers. As I said, I was really, really impressed. And I'm going to go from the first speaker. Am I breaking all the rules here? I'm not very good at following rules, if you don't mind. Can I also talk about the evaluator?
Yes, of course.
Because he is the top dog here, so I have to bow down to him. So I have to bend it. The first evaluator, this lady was very kind, she had a very beautiful voice, excellent English, and everything else. However, I think it wouldn't be too good if you are going to introduce a speaker, but you know nothing about your speaker. And you went ahead and admit that to the audience, saying, well, I don't know my speaker. Okay, that is a not very nice thing to say. Okay, so at least I'm sure you know who you will be introducing, so you should try to find time to ask the speaker you're going to be introducing, find out something about this person. Okay, the other two evaluators did an excellent job, so I think that's something that we all want to learn, because at the end of the day, one day you're going to be one of the speakers that's going to be introduced by an evaluator. And I'm sure that you would like your evaluators to know something about you, make it a personal touch. It's just a little tiny effort, but that makes all the difference. Am I speaking too fast?
No.
No? Are you okay with my accent?
Yeah.
Okay. I know that... and then about this word, translator, I remember one of the ladies here who wanted to become a translator. Is that you, Eva? That's you, right?
Yeah.
But I don't know if you're going to be a translator or you're actually thinking about becoming an interpreter.
Or maybe interpreter.
Okay, good. So, interpreter and translator. These two terms, they are not synonymous. They are not the same. Okay? Well, people sometimes do use one for the other, but actually there is a distinction between the two. An interpreter is like if I say something in English and Jack, I say, Jack, please translate into Chinese for me. And then he is, you know, that's called consecutive interpreting. Not simultaneous interpreting. There are different types of interpretation. So that will be interpreting. But translating is to do with translating texts, okay, written documents, so that's a little different, so I think that's something to clarify as well. And also, I keep hearing students saying, I am chosen to be something. Actually, it should be chosen, okay, but a lot of people keep saying chosen. It's not chosen, it's chosen. It's chosen, not chosen. Well, if you listen to the speeches as carefully as I did, you would have heard that one. What else? There was one gentleman talking about his childhood. He was born in Yilan, Luodong, but then he moved to Taipei when he was three. When you were two or three, yes. Okay, good. And I think you said something is like, I moved to Taipei. And then moved back. Okay. Right. You say something along like you were an exchange student for 1 year and then went to the States, and when you came back, you started sort of rekindle your passion for English. Okay, so that was very memorable. Excellent. And I think, what's your time? Am I dragging on for too long? Dragging on for too long, and I go on and on, okay, for too long. And what was I? About this gentleman. Okay. I think, as I said, for these three speakers, I think very importantly is they have very good poise, and they also look very natural as they are delivering their speeches, and I think that is a very important thing. I'm sure these were prepared speeches, correct? Were they prepared speeches? So actually you wrote your script, and you were just you have rehearsed it several times. But giving the presentations like acting, but even though you're acting, you want to act naturally. So if you have too much intonation going up and down, too many gestures, not necessarily required, that becomes unnatural. Okay. And I think we have three natural speakers, and that's very good. Right. Oh, one more word though. Glamour. A lady talked about glamour, Taiwan being very glamorous. Yes, it's glamorous. Okay, do you know this word? Glamour. Right. And the ADJ is glamorous. Oh, and just a very quick note, I'm running out of time, right? Yes, just a very quick note to this gentleman who talked about this wonderful trip to India. That was a very inspiring speech, and I totally enjoyed it. And you have so many funny stories in there as well, and they just came up so nicely with your pictures, your visual aids, so I enjoyed your speech very much. The only little thing I have for you is when you were talking about this word, you said breathtaking, but it's breathtaking, not breathtaking, and you said it twice, so I think if you can correct that, that would be perfect. Alright, and that's all I have to say. Actually, I have a lot more to say, but I know I've run out of time, so okay, if you will have me back, and then probably will say more. Alright, thank you very much.
Okay, really thanks for the teachers, specifically